Hi, this is Carrie, aka Knit Purl Girl, and what I'm going to show you in this video is how to do the purl stitch. A lot of you identify knitting with this fabric right here. Let's see if my camera will focus on it. If you look at this fabric, we have all these little V's going up the fabric. This is called stockinette stitch, or abbreviated as SS in patterns. To create stockinette stitch fabric, we have to knit a row of knit stitches and then purl a row of purl stitches. So in order to do that, you need to learn the purl stitch. Now remember I said when you knit every stitch in the row and every single row, it's called garter stitch. But again, these have V's on the front side. And on the back side, which is the wrong side of the work, it has all these bumps. These are known as purl bumps. This is on the wrong side of the work. The right side of the work has the V's, the knitted V's. So to begin this, we knit a row of knit stitch, which is the right side of the work. So you're going to knit it just like I showed you how in the other videos. Oops. And you have to excuse me, I'm trying to knit around my camera. Okay, so this is nothing shocking. You've already done this. Okay? Again, you pull your work down so that your work and your yarn so that you don't accidentally add a stitch. Put this in your left hand. When you see all these bumps, that means it's time to purl. Now, we talked about knitting in which we went in the front of the stitch. And we went from front to back. Purling is different. You're gonna come in from back to front. So from behind, you're going to come in this way into the stitch. Okay? Then what you're going to do, oops, my yarn's in the wrong position for this. Then what you're going to do is with the yarn down at the bottom, you're going to bring this yarn in between these two and around. Okay? Then, see how it's there? Then you're going to take this right-hand needle and you're going to pull that yarn through that hole, like that. And you can pop the stitch off. That's one purl stitch. It's a little confusing, so let's do it again. Come in this way. Take this yarn. Come in between these two. Like this. And around. So see how it's sitting in between the left-hand needle and the right-hand needle, and then we brought it around the front. We're going to use the right-hand needle to pull that yarn through the loop, like this, and then pop off the left-hand needle. That's two purl stitches. Let's do it through the end of the row. In, around, pull it through, pop off. Okay, so we've completed a purl row, and the way you can tell that the stitches are purl stitches is that right underneath the stitch there's a bump. And when you turn it onto the right side, right underneath the stitches, there's a V. So that means that the V's are on the right side, and when the V's face you, I'm sorry, hoping my camera will readjust. When the V's are facing you, it's time to knit that row. When the purl bumps are facing you, it's time to purl that row. Okay, so let's do that again. Again, this is called stockinette stitch in the United States. In the UK or in UK patterns, you may see it called stocking stitch. You knit the first row or all right side rows, which in this case happen to be even, or excuse me, the odd rows. Hold on, I have a stitch that needs resituated here. Okay, so we knit that row. We turn the work and put that in the left hand. And now that the purl bumps are all facing me, I know that I need to purl this row. So let's do it again together. Move this in through this stitch in front. Take the yarn. Bring it in between the two and around. Pull it through and pop it off. Oops. Again, I'm sorry about my camera. Not sure how to get the autofocus to stop. Okay. So we've completed a couple rows of stockinette stitch. A few things that you need to know about stockinette stitch. It curls. It will curl on the edges and curl underneath. So if you're making a scarf, a good thing to do is to do a few garter stitches on either side of the main part of the scarf and on the bottom and on the top so that it doesn't curl. But if you like this curling look, it'll curl up almost into a tube. Another thing you need to know is that every V stitch indicates a row. So you can count all these V stitches and count how many rows you've knit. If you were to start out with the purl row first and then a knit row, that's called reverse stockinette. In reverse stockinette, this purl side is the right side of the work. In regular stockinette, this V side is the right side of the work. After you were to bind off, you will always weave your ends in on the wrong side of the work. And that's how to do the purl stitch.